Today I presented how we can optimize clinical trials in precision oncology, and particularly how we can increase the efficacy of these trials. To optimize precision oncology trials, we should first start having comprehensive molecular profiling for all patients with cancer. And this would include not only genomics, but also transcriptomics, proteomics, immune markers, as well as novel markers to assess which trial is best for the patients. Also, we should start doing this at the time of diagnosis and during the course of the disease. We should try to analyze bone marrow, patient's tumor, but also patient's cells, peripheral blood, using cell-free DNA analysis, which gives us the opportunity to monitor real-time, in frequent intervals, patients' alterations to adjust treatment and optimize the results we see with the individualized therapies. We will need combination trials because single agents work in a very small proportion of patients who have specific alterations. Having combinations of drugs on a clinical trial allows us or enables us to target multiple mechanisms of carcinogenesis and therefore overcome resistance mechanisms upfront, as well as to improve the results seen with single agents alone. The availability of clinical trials, only 5% in the United States are enrolled on clinical trials of these patients with cancer. In academic institutions, maybe it is a little higher. The standard of care is that patients receive first standard treatments rather than having molecular testing to optimize their treatment upfront and to monitor the results. The cost is a major issue, of course, insurance coverage, and also access to trials and knowledge, disseminating the knowledge that trials are available for specific alterations and for specific tumor types. And patients, for instance, come to our institution for treatment, but they have to sacrifice a lot and they have to invest time and energy and money to spend time there to participate in these trials. And some of these trials are really very helpful and patients live for a prolonged period of time disease-free. We should try to continue to design novel trials with targeted therapies, with innovative drugs that or strategies that target the biology of cancer, and we should apply this upfront at the time of diagnosis and optimize treatment later on. And also we should try to understand the mechanisms, how these drugs work, because it is important to dissect which is the active drug in a combination, for instance, and which drug is not as helpful in addressing or leading to the tumor activity we notice. The important thing is how, with emerging data and the amount of data we have to process and to be up to date, to offer our patients the best treatment all the time, how can we manage the vast majority of this data? And the answer is, of course, that the use of adaptive design and to allow us to use the best trials possible for our patients is important, and in this aspect I'm the lead investigator of the IMPACT-2 trial. So this trial started in 2014, but because it has adaptive design, allows patients to participate in the best treatments possible for their molecular alterations at every time.